theory, I think jiu-jitsu, it doesn't make us to where we can't get beat up. It gives us a chance against anybody. You know what I mean? That's what jiu-jitsu does. You know, a guy could be better than me, but if he plays with me, I'll catch him. You know what I mean? Because of jiu-jitsu, the techniques of jiu-jitsu. You know, and I think people like Anderson Silva just demonstrated that in his last fight. I mean, you had to say, Khael Sonnen was all over him. He was killing him, right? He knew jiu-jitsu and pulled that fight out.
Days, like, my survival is based a lot on my flexibility and my ability to squirm out of positions, as opposed to my ability to, like, technically get out of something or technically work my way into something. And if I had to give myself some advice back then, I would say abandon the flexibility or really try to focus on your technique and see what you can improve upon there, as opposed to always using your flexibility to get out of things. Anybody would tell you right now, you're using too much strength, don't power out of this. That's a fairly common thing to say. But my flexibility at that point was just as much of a crutch, or your speed or your size or anything else. But in my case, it was definitely my flexibility. Once I got to that point where I understood that my flexibility, like, was a crutch as opposed to, like, aiding me, and that I really had to focus on my technique, I think my game got quite a bit better when I started focusing on that. Natural ability will help you to a certain extent. The main thing you have to know, though, is that your natural ability, your strength, your size, your speed, your flexibility, whatever God-given talent you have, can never be used as a substitute for technique. Okay, they can only be used to enhance your technique. Okay, if you rely on that stuff too much, you know, there's always going to be somebody bigger, stronger, faster, or more flexible, and then without your technique, where are you? Okay, but if you have the technique first and then learn how to use your talents to enhance that technique, then you can legitimately get better, and then you can say that you're starting to master your own body and master the, or starting on the path at least, to getting better at jiu-jitsu.
Don't have the ego. I used to struggle with that. I would be training sometimes, I would do really well, and I'd get tired to go sit on the wall. And how great was my instructor. He would come up to me and he'd say, I want you to train more. And I would say, oh, okay, I'll train more. So I come in the next day and the day after that. And a couple days later, he said, hey, I want you to train more. And I was like, well, I'm coming in almost every day now. So I said, okay, I'm gonna make it every day now. I'm gonna come in every day. The problem was I was coming in every day, but I wasn't training. I was training, doing well, and then sitting out, and I'd be sitting on the wall. And it didn't strike me that that's what he's talking about. It's like, hey, don't sit on the wall. You get tired, keep training. So biggest advice I could give myself is, look, man, don't get caught up in if you're looking good, you're looking bad, if you're doing well, if the instructor is, you know, thinks you're not going to get a belt because you're tapping a lot. That's all garbage. I would tell myself, man, just train. Train as much as you can. Get as tired as you can. Keep training. And every class, try to take it up a notch. You know, you do 20 minutes one day, try to do 22 minutes the next day. Then take it up and up and up.
Everything that I've had in my life experience has made me who I am today, and I'm really happy with that. I'm really happy with my life, and, you know, I think that's the key too. I mean, there was like one match that I had when I was younger, when I fought Hickson's son, Kron, and you know, I fought him a couple times and I lost to him, and I think one of the biggest things that I walked away was that, you know, he was very mentally prepared, and like for me, like I felt like at that point that was one thing that I was lagging. Ever since that point, like, I was like 15, I was an orange belt. Like, I've kind of been on this quest, like, to master the mind, you know? for me, like, if you ever sit down and you talk to me, you always hear me say that. Like, that's how I see the world. Like, if you focus on what you want, you're in that vibe, and that's what you're gonna get, because that's what you're attracting to you. And when you're being positive about it, even if things are down, you're always expecting it. So it's gonna make you focus. You know, it's a lot easier to focus, I think, on something that you want to achieve when you're in that positive mindset than when you're not. Because, like, when you're like questioning yourself and all that, you know, you don't feel good. But like, when you're like, man, I believe in myself, I could do this, you know, you do it, you know. So I would just say, like I said, just focus on what you want and be positive.
I really think Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu gives women a chance in a real fight. Because in theory, I think Jiu-Jitsu, it doesn't make us to where we can't get beat up. It gives us a chance against anybody. You know what I mean? That's what Jiu-Jitsu does. You know, a guy could be better than me, but if he plays with me, I'll catch him. You know what I mean? Because of Jiu-Jitsu, the techniques of Jiu-Jitsu. So, you know, like here, I'm trying to attract more women onto the mat, and I'm trying to find out a way to let them know this is the art that's really going to give you a realistic opportunity if you're being attacked. You know, you're 115-pound female. The odds of you of palm healing some guy in the face and taking him out who has experience in violence, right? It's just not that high. Even among the boxing community, only 2% of the boxing community possesses a one-punch knockout.
Really?
Yeah. So what makes us average folks walking around thinking we're going to hit this guy and he's going to hit the floor and it's going to be over, right? It's a fallacy. It really is. But some systems teach that. You know, you're gonna hit him in his nose, and hit him in his gut, and then kick him in between his legs, and, you know, he's going to be on the ground begging you for mercy. And, you know, and what happens, they get in the streets and find out that the person of the street he's the one with the experience with violence, not you. You're the one that is hesitant with it. So the odds are you're not going to hit this person and knock him out. You're not going to kick him and take him out. If you had those kind of abilities, you'd probably be in Muay Thai or boxing or something, you know? and so you need something that is going to give you a chance when you're being overwhelmed. And that's Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu.